Hi there, thanks for tuning in. What we have loading here, as you can see, is Mutant Monty from Arctic, written by Carl Jeffrey. Now, Carl didn't do many Spectrum games. In fact, I'm not sure if he did any after this, but he ended up becoming quite a mover in the video game industry. So this is where he started with Mutant Monty. Now, it's kind of like, I suppose you would call it a platformer or a Manic Miner clone. Very similar in theme, I guess, but it's quite different in a couple of ways, as we'll see. The plot is basically you play Monty, the Monty of the title, who is basically after two things. To get rich and become the hero by saving the damsel in distress. And he does this by collecting all the gold in each screen, which then enables him to move on to the next one. And presumably at some point in the game there is a damsel in distress which he can rescue as well. But what Monty is not aware of is that there are lots of aliens in his way, including the bizarrely named Parallelians. So here we are, as you can see, nice little intro. Here we go, it's Arctic Computing presenting Mutant Monty. There's the cassette just stopping there. So let's just have a little look at what we've got here. A few options there. Keyboard, I think we'll go with keyboard control. I believe there's a nice little tune of the entertainer playing as the game proceeds. So there was the damsel in distress. And as you can see, there's Monty in the middle of your screen. And the little lumps here is the gold that he has to collect. And when he finally collects all this, he can escape from the exit, as you can see flashing there. Monty's lives in the bottom left-hand corner, and the time in the bottom right-hand corner. So let's have a look, see what we can do here. So I remember the controls. Oh, yeah. Now, the thing with this game, he zips around, and he doesn't have to climb up or jump up things. Monty actually is kind of just fixed in the game. So there we go. You can see that music's going to get a bit irritating. As you can see, he moves really, really quickly, and the control is a bit tight. So now, I have played this game a bit already, and there's a couple of things that are a bit annoying with it. First of all, that tune, and the second thing is the collision detection's a bit off. And also, when you're trying to get him to move into a particular hole, it can be quite tricky. Right. There we go. So we hide down here. And the job is to collect all these bits of gold, as I say, whilst avoiding these aliens. He doesn't seem to move very quickly when you want him to, but he's gathered that okay. He's all over the place, really. The trick is kind of to push yourself up against a wall or something to stabilise him a little bit. And there he is, right at the top there now. I have already completed this level a couple of times, so shouldn't be too bad at doing this. And there we go. There's the exit, a little bonus for time left over. Now this is the next screen, and this is the one I've really had trouble with, I must admit. As you can see, the collision takes a little off, unfortunately. It's probably based on characters, that's the problem. Can't use the exit yet, you have to collect this gold. And I must admit I've had two or three goes of this and I haven't managed to get past this little bit here. Obviously you've got to wait and negotiate these droplets and this funny little flashing thing. But with Monty being quite difficult to control, this game takes a bit of getting used to. Coupled with the rather harsh collision detection. Oh, that looks familiar. Instead of a boot down, it's a finger pushing Monty away. This is quite a popular game back in the early days of the Spectrum. 1984 it was released by Arctic. At the time, really, Speccy games didn't have to be that amazing to be well considered. I can't remember what the reviews were like, but I should imagine it was probably and maybe a little bit unfairly tarnished as a Jet Set Willy stroke Manic Miner clone, which is a bit unfair because although it looks like that, it's a little bit different to that in that Monty can move sort of like freely around the screen. But whereas this first screen is not too difficult, it didn't take me too long to work out how to get around this. I suppose it's just a question, really, of a bit of patience and working it out at the right time. Because I can imagine if I get past this bit here, which I almost did there, then it might not be too difficult, this screen. The thing that is a bit difficult to get a grip with is that Monty moves to the left and right really quickly, but up and down quite slowly, which is makes it a little bit trickier. So there you go, there's Mutant Monty, an early game from Arctic and Carl Jeffrey. Stay tuned and I'll post another video soon. Cheers, bye.